Good morning everyone. Today I'm going to explain Dirac delta function. This is also called impulse function. So now what do you mean by Dirac delta function? This Dirac delta function, this is very useful in electrical engineering, physics and mechanical engineering, where the concept of impulse is used. So basically, impulse that may be interpreted as a force of very large magnitude applied for just an instant. So for a while, the magnitude of the function is very, very large, and after that and before that it is zero. So basically, Dirac delta function at any point zero is zero when t is not zero, and when it is zero, it is infinity. Or you can say Dirac delta function at any point A is zero when t is not equal to A. So discontinuity occurs at A. And the discontinuity is not piecewise discontinuity. Here the discontinuity is infinite discontinuity. So your function is defined like this. Before A, the value of the function is zero. After A, the value of the function is zero. But at A, it fluctuates. The magnitude is very, very large. It is going to infinity. Right? So this is Dirac delta function at zero and at A. Now, how to find out the Laplace transform of this function? First of all, we define this function in the terms of unit step function. So in the terms of unit step function, we can write this function in the terms depending on k. Let's suppose I'm going to define the Dirac delta function at A. So this says that before A, the value of function is zero. Between A and A plus k, the value of function is 1 over k, and after a plus k, the value of the function is again 0. So when you take k tending to 0, basically you have at a, the value of function is infinity. Before a and after a, you get the value of the function is 0. So which is your Dirac delta function at a? So we can define this Dirac delta function in the terms of delta k. And when we take k tending to 0, we get this is nothing but Dirac delta function at A. Now this is our piecewise continuous function. We can express this piecewise continuous in the terms of unit step. We get 0 multiplied by unit step at A plus 1 over k unit step at A minus unit step at A plus k plus 0 into unit step at A plus k. Right? So basically this function can be expressed as this one. So now just see what you have. You have the Dirac delta function in the terms of k is unit step at a minus unit step at a plus k times 1 over k. So we can find out the Laplace of this function. So it will be, we can take constant to outside, the Laplace of unit step at a minus the Laplace of unit step at a plus k. So we can apply the second shifting theorem over here. We know that the Laplace of unit step at a into the function at t minus a is the Laplace of f into e to the power minus as. So here your function is 1. So Laplace of 1 is 1 over s. So this will be e to the power minus as upon s. This will be e to the power minus a plus k times s upon s. We can take e to the power minus as to be common, and we get this is 1 over e to the power minus ks upon k into s. So this is the Laplace transform of Dirac delta function in terms of k. Now we can take the limit k approaching to 0. So when we take k tending to 0, what will we have? This function is nothing but Dirac delta at a, and the Laplace of this will be the Laplace of this, which is the Laplace of, you can say, the you can take limit to outside, the Laplace of Dirac delta at A in terms of k. So this will be e to the power minus as 1 minus e to the power minus ks upon ks, the limit k going to 0. This is independent of k, this is depending on k. When you put k tending to 0, you get 1 minus 1 0 upon 0 form. So we can apply the L'Hopital rule. We get 1, the derivative of 1 is 0, e to the power minus ks, the derivative of this will be with respect to k, this will be minus minus plus s times e to the power minus ks upon s. This ss cancel out and we get this is 1. So we get this is nothing but e to the power minus as. This limit is 1 when you take k tending to 0. So the Laplace transform of Dirac delta function is e to the power minus as. However, this function is not of piecewise continuous. This function is not piecewise continuous. Even then we can find out the Laplace of it, and its Laplace is e to the power minus as. So what will be the Laplace of Dirac delta function when a is 0? This is e to the power minus 0s means 1. So it means the Laplace inverse of 1 is the Dirac delta function at 0. So one can use this. Okay, so this Laplace inverse of e to the power minus as will be the Dirac delta function at a. So in this way we can use it in the to find out the inverse Laplace transform of this function. Further is the filtering property of Dirac delta function. That says that whenever ft is continuous function, ft be continuous and integrable in the interval 0 to infinity, then the integral of 0 to infinity ft delta t minus a dt is f at a. So one can use this filtering property to find out the value of the integral of this form. You can see over here, this is the 0 to infinity e to the power minus st Dirac delta at a into dt. This is nothing but e to the power minus as. So if you consider this two as a function of t, so if you apply this filtering property, so what will be your the value of integral? This one you can see easily, if you replace t with a, you get e to the power minus as, which is f at a. So whenever your function is continuous and integrable on in the interval 0 to infinity, the value of this integral is e to the power minus as, and this is called filtering property of Dirac delta function. Right. Now just see with the help of an example how to apply, how to find out, you can say, the solution of some initial value problem where the Dirac delta function is involved. So here Dirac delta function is involved in the right hand side under the condition y at 0 is 0 and y prime at 0 is 0. We have to find out the solution of this initial value problem using Laplace transform. One can see in differential equation there is no method to find out the solution of a differential equation with the function which is not even piecewise continuous. We cannot find out the solution, there are no methods, but using Laplace transform you can find out the solution of such differential equations. So now what is the procedure? First you take the Laplace transform to both sides. The Laplace of y double prime is s square ys, where ys is the Laplace of y minus s times y at 0 minus y prime at 0 plus 2 times the Laplace of y dash, which is s times ys minus y at 0 plus 5 times Laplace of y, which is ys, is equal to the Laplace of Dirac delta function at 2, which is e to the power minus 2s. Now you substitute the value of y prime at 0 and y at 0. So after simplifying we get this is this times ys is equal to e to the power minus 2s. You can take this term to this side. This is the complete square s plus 1 whole square plus 2 square. Right? Now, since here e to the power minus as is involved and some function of s is given to us, so we have to apply the second shifting theorem to find out this. Since ys is this one, so taking inverse to Laplace transform both sides, we get yt. And since using second shifting theorem, we know that the Laplace inverse of e to the power minus as into fs is the unit step at a into f of t minus a. So first of all, find out the Laplace inverse of fs. So we have to divide and multiply with 2. This is the Laplace inverse of sine 2t, and here s is shift with s plus 1, so e to the power minus t into sine of 2t. This is the Laplace inverse of this function. Right, now unit step is involved over here, so we can write unit step at 2, this is the constant, and shift t with t minus a. So this is the solution of this initial value problem. Here the function, which is not even piecewise continuous, is involved in the right hand side, but we can find out the solution of this differential equation using the Laplace transform. You can see one more example. Let's suppose we have to find out the Laplace transform of Dirac delta function at 3. So it will be what? E to the power minus 3s. Right? So using Dirac delta function, we can find out the Laplace transform of the following function.